Hi everybody, and welcome to my channel, and welcome back to my Growing Together LP. So in the last part, we celebrated both Love Day and Mother's Day all together, and it ended on a note of us trying for a baby. I wonder if we're pregnant. She doesn't look like she is, but Lydia is definitely pregnant. I played a day off screen, and we are officially eating for two with two toddlers and an infant already. What am I doing? But it's what my sons wanted. Lydia's been wanting to have a child for the past couple of parts, and in the last part, DeAndre, who is off at class at the current moment, even though he is missing work, is wanted to try for a baby during their celebration of Love Day. So I figured it's time to welcome a new member to this household. So it's a Monday late morning, and Lydia's up making breakfast for her toddler, so they have something to eat, and she is because she's hungry. But we are going to actually hang out with Jocelyn today. I believe she is supposed to be off today. Ooh, bills are due. Ooh, okay, we got money to pay bills. And then once DeAndre comes back from work and Lydia gets her pay for today, I had her take some time off because, girls, she's got morning sickness, and she's going to hang out with Jocelyn for a little bit today because Jocelyn's been reaching out to her, and they actually got a sentiment. Her and Zoe got one this morning as well. Jocelyn has been appreciating her friendly advice, so I figured it's time to have them actually hang out. Ooh, did not mean to grab that. Lydia has been trying her best to get close with Jocelyn. It's just not always easy because they don't always have the best conversation topics. All right, you are up, sir. So let's go ahead and put on some clothes for the day. Let's put that on and come and grab you some food because you guys will be going to daycare as well as Zoe, because as much as I would like to take the kids along with me, it's a lot to handle, and I am trying to get on Jocelyn's good side. I know she needs to see the grandkids, but also DeAndre's a little upset with her. So let's not take the grandkids to see her without him being around. He is back from class, and I believe that's all the class he had for the day. I'm trying to make sure before I send him off to work. Yes, okay, he doesn't have more classes until tomorrow, so we definitely need for him to head off to class, but I'm gonna have him head off to work, pay the bills, and then go to work, sir. Please and thank you. Come on. And we are officially in summer. We are on day two of summer. It's been so long of spring. Hopefully we'll get a little bit more warmer weather. It is sunny today. It was kind of sunny at the end of the last part. All right, DeAndre's off to work. All right, look at her chatting it up. Okay, goodness. Let's see. Brighten her day. Let me see. Is there any other milestone options that we have? Because now that we are officially in summer, it's age up time for our kids. We are in the final week for Zoe, so I have got to try to get her to crawling at least. I don't think we're going to get all, I think it's like 31 plus milestones, I believe, for infants. I'm going to try. I'm trying. She got one yesterday. But yeah, she ages up into a toddler on Father's Day, and then the toddlers age up into kids on Sunday. So we don't got a whole lot of time to try to get any milestones that we can get left for their current stages. And I think you can't really see it when you open it up, but she wants to learn studying shapes. I think that's one. I don't know. There's probably plenty other hidden ones for toddlers. I haven't fully checked out like the full list of all the different milestones for each life stage. Did Kaysen eat? Okay, he is. Oh, he did. Perfect. Okay, the toddlers ate. They're good to go. So we can go out of the house once we clean out the fridge. And hopefully we can have a nice little outing with Jocelyn, and the kids will be well taken care of at daycare. All right, guys, so here we are at a cafe that I placed down in San Sequoia. Like I said in the last part, I was going to replace the rental lot that came with the world. I was like, I highly doubt. I think I'll probably always replace that lot, to be honest, because yes, I appreciate them giving us vacation lots, but Every world does not need to come with a vacation lot. So yes, I found a cafe on the gallery. I don't remember who created this one. It might have been Lil Simzy. I'm not sure. I just been placing lots down, just searching the gallery, not fully paying attention to it. So yes, it's right across from the library, which kind of makes sense. The cafe, it's in the business area of San Sequoia, so why not? All right, so let's try to see if we can have a lovely outing with Jocelyn. She seems to be in a good mood. Ooh, girl. Swap baby milestone stories. We're actually not going to let her know that we are pregnant because we have not told DeAndre. Technically, because we found out last night while he was working on his term paper, so Lydia kind of didn't get the chance to share it with him before she went to bed. So, and then he's been off busy this morning. So, she's not hungry right now, but if Jocelyn wants to order anything, give a smooth apology. Technically, Jocelyn needs to be apologizing, but you know, Lydia's just trying to be the mediator in the situation. She just wants Jocelyn to be around for her grandchildren. All right, so let's see. Talk about cooking with her. Let's see if we can boast about family. She'll appreciate that. She has been she's been asking us about for advice lately. So I figured why not do that? Compliment her outfit. Hey doctor, this is a private thing. Thank you. Like a breath of fresh air, looks like Lydia just befriended a nature enthusiast. Who? Jocelyn? Nature enthusiasts are passionate about the natural world Sims live in, which can make them super fun Sims to hang out with, especially outdoors. In terms of Sim preference, would you say that Lydia likes nature enthusiasts? I'm assuming that the doctor who just sat down is a nature enthusiast because I don't believe Jocelyn is. And it's not a problem with her liking them, but I kind of don't need you in this conversation. Tell her a funny story. You're right, because I'm not trying to let my mother-in-law know that I'm pregnant yet before I let my husband know. That's what I was trying to say. So gossip about neighbors. I don't know if Jocelyn will like gossip, but you know. Express admiration for her. Ooh, look at their bar. Tell her a dramatic story as well. You're feeling very energized right now, which is perfect for a cafe. I think she's gonna go order something, or is she, where are you going? We were having a nice little chat. Oh, she went to grab a book. We don't even technically know you, and you just sat down at the table. Do a chill for introduction, I guess, because or respectful. I mean, he is a doctor, and if story progression doesn't get him before you have the baby, he most likely will be the doctor. Boast about family to him. Doesn't hurt getting to know the doctor before you have to go in. Gossip about other parents with him as well. Discuss gourmet dishes. Try to bring Jocelyn in on this. Uh-oh, she's getting embarrassed. Oh no, what about? I feel so fat. Girl, I can barely tell you're pregnant. So, calm down. Uh-oh, she about to go throw up. She's been trying to hold it in. You did good, girl. You did good. You held it in as long as you could. Oh. Ooh. But I mean, we boosted it. We boosted our relationship. Oh, they're considered friends now. Yay, they're no longer considered acquaintance. You did good. Okay, and let's brush our teeth as well, because we don't want to go back to our mother-in-law with funky breath. And DeAndre is home. We're going to let him stay with the kids, but we'll head home in just a moment. Jocelyn looked like she's ordering something. DeAndre picked them up from daycare. Thanks. Hello, Jocelyn. We were chatting over here. Come sit with me. I know that's our original table, but you know, we kind of had a crowd. Mentions selfless generosity as well. Let's have a deep conversation with her. Oh no. Okay. It's getting awkward. Jocelyn, calm down. All right. There we go. I think we've had a nice little chat with Jocelyn. We're going to have a deep conversation. Look at that. See? Jocelyn's throwing the jokes now. Yeah, I think it's time for us to head on back home. We had a nice little chat with her. Let's see if we can get I'm going to let her order something because she's been trying to order something for a minute. But also, I want to give her a hug. Oh, perfect. Right there. I was about to say, please don't make me have to go dip. I probably should have let her grab it. You'll grab it in a second. We're going to give her a hug, and then we're going to head on home. As she gains some charisma, we're gonna head on home. Thanks for the hangout, Jocelyn. Oh yeah, let's go, because she's got negative about us. Let's head on out. Hopefully now we can go home and tell our husband we're pregnant and try to get him to make it up with his mother. We'll see. We're trying to work on that. All right, guys, so we are home, and let's check in on our family. Let's see how the kitties. They all seem to be okay. Well, Mrs. needs a nap, and she's playing with Daddy's Valentine's Day gift. Go ahead and take you a nap. It's kind of late, but go ahead and take you a nap, sweetie. I don't even know how you got Daddy's toy. And my infant is in here staring at the broken washer. All right, so now that y'all have had a chit-chat, can someone please go get my infant, please, that's just staring at the broken washer. Come and repair the plumbing on this. You, ma'am, come and comfort her and get her out of this. She probably needs a nap as well. No, she doesn't. It says she does, but her energy is actually really not that bad. We can work on some tummy time or practice crawling, because that's what we definitely need to get going. Practice crawling with her. Oh, is this water everywhere? Okay, I'm glad that the toddler seemed to be... Mop seemed to be getting along a little bit better with Zoe. Zoe's not as welcoming though, but that's just Zoe though. Hopefully her toddler trait, you know what? I don't feel like the traits sometimes even matter, because them quirks be like, no, we're gonna completely change the temperament of this toddler. All right, let's work on crawling with her, because I definitely want to get her crawling. So she's been scooting for far too long. Let's get her to the crawling stage, please. All right, yeah, let's clean that up, sir. And then I need for you also to work on your homework, because I still don't understand how you got a D last term. Excuse me, I keep saying D. It was a D plus, technically. And let's also probably make sure we edit our presentation and term paper. I'm trying to make sure we get all of the extra stuff done, because I don't want any more D pluses. We got to get our GPA up, because I don't want to lose all them good scholarships that we got as well. So, because if we lose our GPA, we do lose scholarships. I don't want that to happen, because we definitely need the scholarships, because we got no money. And she needs to use the bathroom. Are you working on crawling? Because I don't feel like you're just doing tummy time with her. After you're done with that, please go ahead and use the bathroom before you have a bladder failure with so many toilets on this lot. Sir, can you also get out of your work clothes as well? Because... granted, your work clothes is better than your wife's, but I'll clean that up for you. Zoe, what you doing? Trying to go night-night? You could, or you can try tummy time, sweetie. I'm sorry. I really want you to... I know you want to go night-night, but I need for you to start crawling, and I need for you to work on as much of stuff that you can do on your own. Because you about to, and this sounds bad, get pushed out of the way, because we're going to have another young one on us. All right, let's also vacuum lightly. I swear the dust be collecting way too fast. Let me put that away before that spoils. No, what do you need? What do you need? Okay, I mean, I didn't mean to exit out of that. Talk to your dad, but you don't need to be in the high chair for that. Leave him. He's fine. He was talking to his dad just fine. Talk about your day with your dad. Or he can put you up. All right, that's fine. Are we turning? Okay. We might get... Ooh. Come on, Zoe. Come on, sweetie. Come on. Look, you're turning and everything. You know you want to start crawling. Why is this so entertaining to watch her just sit here and twirl in a circle? All right, your big sister's up. What's going on? She's going to the potty. Okay, good. And DeAndre needs sleep, but he also wants to cook dinner. So let's brew, well, no point in coffee, but let's just go ahead and serve up some dinner because it is getting late. Oh, okay, I'm coming. Mommy's coming. I don't know where mommy's at. Okay, let's forget vacuuming for right now. Let's comfort her a little bit and give her a bottle. and then put her to bed. She's been working hard over here. I'm trying to get her to crawling because we only have some limited days. Like, you literally got to do, like, tummy time, like, a couple times a day, I think, to get all the milestones. And I'm playing on long, so I don't know how you can possibly get all the milestones if you play on normal. At least for me, because I don't play on normal often anyway, so I'm not used to playing. I play legacies, yes, but I haven't played a legacy all the way through yet with. But I had this pause, I was like, wait a minute, no. I started a legacy recently, and I have made it. But I still don't think my infant, she got, I think, all but one milestone. So it's like, it's still hard even on long. Ooh, oh, that was watery, Zoe. That was watery. Let's go ahead and put her to bed. Let's put her to sleep. This is cute. I wish you weren't throwing that bottle with your toddler so close to you and knives. Can we cut the tricks out with the young one next to you? All right, you actually wanted to, one of your milestones, I think it's a study shapes. Spell words, I guess. I don't know if that counts technically as studying shapes is what it was. But I don't see the study shapes option. You, I know you were not just crying about bed, Mr. Who likes to avoid bed. Like literally, you'll do anything not to go to bed. That's why you're always tired. All right, let's get, what did I have you do? Chili. Let's go ahead and get this chili done. Yes, okay. Zoe is down for the night. Even though she's mad that she was put down. Ma'am, I'm sorry. She did have the lesbian hell quirk, but we definitely did not hold her a lot. That is the one quirk we did not pay attention to very much. Hug him lovely. Because actually, let me check your sentiments. Yeah, the ignored is still very strong from you, and he gonna be real mad when you hug lovingly. I wonder if they can get that as children as well. Tell a funny story. Let's see. I wonder if apologize, talk about siblings with him to let him know, like, hey, you are the oldest. You have two. You about to have another. And we also need to tell our husband that we're about to have another as well. Because when do we hit second trimester? In 15 hours. So I actually have my sim pregnancy set to like 5 sim days instead of the 3. And I used to play it on 6 sim days. So I used to know it was like 2 sim days per trimester. Don't know how much it equates to now. It's like a day and a half, maybe, or a little less than that. Because sometimes can't really. He'll be okay. You'll be okay. Did we get, oh, he got a new sentiment though. No, it just re-triggered. Got it. I don't know what you want. Oh no, maybe I was on the wrong person. I just didn't clear it from him. Okay. No, but it's still strong. Oh, Lydia reached level 8. Apparently, Lydia now has a third option for all teaching moments. She can also more effectively perform discipline socials. Which is perfect because we're definitely going to need to discipline it the way these toddlers have been acting. At least Kaysen. Kennedy actually has calmed down. Speaking of which, he in here quietly playing. She is not going to eat this chili. So, DeAndre, let's give her some peas. The only food that I know for a fact. Oh, and we got to give Zoe food too. There's so much to do. Let's give her peas since that seems to be the only thing Kennedy enjoys eating. Kaysen, you can. I know you're going to avoid bed, but use the potty and go to sleep. Please and thank you. Your mom is going to grab her a bowl of chili. Thank you. I don't know where she was heading. Just grab you a bowl of chili, get you some food. Let's feed Mrs. I know she don't like being picked up. But the only food you like is available on the high chair. I'm sorry. You made the awkward decision to be like this. All right, let's clean this up. DeAndre, I was going to have you work on your term paper or something, but you are exhausted. You take a day off from work tomorrow, so you just won't have to worry about your classes. Put that away. Let the Mrs. Queen out. And take yourself a shower and head off to bed. because you've had a busy day, and Miss Kennedy will head herself off to bed as well. And as everyone kind of bunkers down, guys, I'm gonna meet you in the morning. All right, guys, it is the next morning. I feel you, Lydia. I'm so embarrassed because you still went to bed and we have not told DeAndre that you're pregnant. It's just so hectic in this household. Miss Infant Zoe is in their crib practicing tummy time because, like I said, we've got to get as much milestones as we possibly can before Saturday. Saturday is her birthday. I'm not ready for it at all. All right, DeAndre did take his time off. So what time is his first class? I think it's at like 9:30. Okay, he's got time, but I do need for him to get up soon. I'm going to try to let him sleep a little bit longer. So go ahead and sleep in, sir. Lydia's having morning sickness again. But let's go ahead and feed infant Zoe. I keep calling her baby Zoe, and I got to stop doing that. Bottle feed her because it's definitely time. Oh, wait, no. Don't bottle feed her. I keep forgetting. No. You know what's time for? It's time to put her in the high chair. Help her try her first explore food. So let's see. Let's do rice porridge. I feel like that's what I always hear. That is usually the baby's very first thing to eat as something more solid than breast milk or formula or whatever they may be having. And let's see how this goes. Hopefully it will go very well. She's in her sleepwear that has a passy on it, so it's gonna look a little weird though. So, aw, my coworker knows my mother-in-law. Hey, I heard you became friends with Jocelyn Lewis. She's pretty cool. Yeah, I know. I'm trying to get her to think I'm cool too. It's a little bit of work, but hopefully it will go all well. Zoe is frowning. All right, girl, try it out. How you feeling about it? Let me know. Oh, she's unsure. Oh, okay, there we go. This food is also not doing very much for her hunger, though. I'll probably have to give her more than one. I kind of want to put her in another sleepwear, though, because she looks so cute in this bunny, but she has a pasty on this one. And I kind of want to see how she looks. Oh, DeAndre's class. Okay, hold on. Let me get him up because I've been trying to have him shave as well. So much is going on. Like, it's hard to keep up everything. Let's brush your teeth. Shave facial hair. No, can we shave it to your preferred length though? Because I don't want you to shave all the way down. I guess not. I guess because it's that big, it's time to just shave it all the way down. That's fine. And then let's change up our outfit for today. I guess we could put that on. And let's also try. All right. Let Zoe explore something else. Let's give her oatmeal as well. Let's see how... Ooh, she's got food all over her face. Yeah, let's hold on. Let me change her outfit real quick. All right, I had to put her in some everyday clothes because I forgot both of her sleepwear actually have passies on it. Sorry, I had to get me my screenshot in. Oh, she looks a mess but cute at the same time. Oh, she's unsure about that. But you know what? With her cautious trait, I'm not surprised. I am not surprised at all. Let me see how her... Okay, it's not doing too bad for hunger now. So you're like, two tries of food will actually fill up her hunger. DeAndre, need for you to hurry up and get ready for school, sir. Can we get her to try something else? Oh, we can also... Right, because she can reach. We can help her do finger foods as well. So let's give her, we'll do banana slices. Let's see how you feel about that. Oh, look at her sucking her thumb. Let's get her to try some banana slices as well. We can knock out another milestone right there. Oh, she tried it herself. Usually the parents like give it to them for the first time. Zoe's like, I've been ready for this. You're the one that's been holding me back. Ooh. Oh my goodness, and she let it out. Did the bananas go right to you, sweetie? All right, where you going? Oh, you didn't change your clothes in time. Let's not. Yep, he can completely clean shaven himself, which is fine. Zoe is over here having a blast in her bananas. He's off to class. Let's make sure that we take some notes. You go ahead. Is she okay? Uh-oh. What's wrong? Oh, you need a bath, but I'm gonna let you finish enjoying your bananas. But as they do that, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wind off this part of my Growing Together LP right here. If you enjoyed it, please go ahead and leave your comments and suggestions down below. Hit that like button because you know you want to. Go ahead and get you some food while she's enjoying her bananas. Hit that like button because you know you want to. Subscribe if you haven't, and hit that bell button so you get notified every time I upload a video. And until next time, guys, bye. Girl, how you feel about the bananas? Ooh, you a mess. A cute mess, though.